recently you gave a performance with the Chatham Chorale that the Cape Cod Times said lifted the souls of the audience. What does it feel like to do that to an audience, to move so many people?
I think it's a group effort, definitely. I always enjoy singing with the chorale because I have so many friends in the chorale. It also brings in the group effort of Joe, the director, of the orchestra, of the chorus, and of the soloist. The Mozart was something that I've visited in many, many times in my life. The first time I sang La Laudate Domino was actually in college, and I'm trying to find that tape to see what that sounds like. And then, of course, it's popped up as a single piece in my church work. I directed it and played it, and I also sung it. I had never done the whole Solemn Vespers by myself, the whole work, so that was definitely, it's always exciting to do something that you haven't done before, as well as revisit old friends.
And when did this all start for you?
When I was in school, you pretty much had to choose between band or chorus, and I chose band. So I was very involved in that. I did some singing every now and then. You had the time to do a little bit with chorus. My first piano teacher, actually, somehow, I don't remember how she figured that out, but she was the organist at the Baptist Church, and she had me go and sing a couple of solos when I was a teenager. So His Eye is on the Sparrow and Great is Thy Faithfulness were my first solo pieces.
Many people know you as a classical music singer. And do you restrict your music to classical music, or are you also involved in other forms?
Oh, I really enjoy the American Songbook. In fact, with my friend Richard Bush, we often put together some recitals. We did a Harold Arlen show this year, and Gershwin, Cole Porter, all of those. Another one of my favorite types of music is Celtic music. I have a friend who plays Celtic harp, and I played flute on that program, and some singing. But that type of music fascinates me as well. So,
many people have noted the serenity that you have before an audience. How can you explain that?
I recently re-found a quotation that I had found from another soprano about the singer breathes in air and breathes out love to the audience, especially because most of the music that I sing is of a spiritual nature. I both take that in to calm myself, and it's also a focus of what I'm sharing with the audience. And especially when I'm on Cape Cod, there's almost always a few people that I know there. And if I look out and see someone smiling at me, how can you not feel serene, because you feel supported?
Speaking of smiling, what is the funniest thing that happened to you ever on stage?
Well, let's see, in the most recent chorale performance, I almost missed my chair. The other thing that happened in the chorale a few years ago was that I had the wrong edition of the Vivaldi Gloria, and so I was the second soprano soloist for that, and we practiced the duet, and somehow I kept getting, I wasn't ending at the same time she was, so they found me at the correct score. So we were doing two Vivaldi pieces, and now they both were the same color, and so for the first half I picked up what I thought was the correct score, and just before my solo I noticed that I had the wrong score. And Maggie Bossy was directing at that point, and so she was getting ready to start the movement, and I was trying to get her attention, Maggie, and Maggie, I have the wrong score. And she looked at me, and she kind of, you know, got a hold of the situation, and then she marched up into the tenor section and snatched a score from one poor tenor and came back and gave it to me, and the audience tittered, and we went on with the performance. So, but from then on, you know, everybody in the chorale said, Joan, do you have the right music? Are you ready?
That's so amazing. Did you always know that you had such a good sense of humor? I think everyone who knows you would say that that's part of the spark of Joan Kirchner, that you have such a great sense of humor.
I think that develops as you get more comfortable with yourself.
So as a little girl, you were not someone necessarily that people said.
I was very quiet.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up in a very, one would say, restrictive home. not that I didn't have fun, but it tended to be, I still enjoy for recharging my batteries to go for a walk in the woods. And so being alone in nature was very important to me. And we lived out in the country, so I didn't interact with a lot of people. So I think you have to have that give and take with other people to develop a rapport and a sense of humor and that kind of take on things. And you know, if as you go through life you don't start to see things as funny, you're going to have a hard time.
you're cooked. Mm-hmm. So you studied music extensively. How did that proceed? In high school, did you start studying music in high school, or was it just at the college level?
It was at the college level. My parents had me slated to get a business degree, which I do have, actually. And I went off to college, and we had picked a school that also had a good music program. And I found out I did, obviously, some study in high school through the flute, mainly, flute and piano. When I went to college, my parents had me slated to be a business major, and I do actually have a business degree, but we did pick a college that had a strong music program. And I took some organ lessons, some piano and some organ lessons, and I was desperately trying to find something that I could do
in music. What is next for you? You have so many things going on with your performances and your lessons. What's next on the agenda?
The next big performance is actually off Cape, up in Gloucester with Carmina Burana. So I need to be exercising those high notes you were talking about. The theater project that I'm involved with, called Mama and Her Boys, with three other Cape talents, is going to return to our home at Cape Rep Theater at the end of the month. So we are definitely getting that back up to speed, fine-tuning, changing a little bit. And of course, we're coming up to June, so that's wedding month. So, and there's several projects in the summer that are kind of taking shape. So
how do people find you? Let's say someone on the Cape is planning a wedding. How would they get in touch with you?
Very often, they can call the Cape Cod Conservatory. Many times, they just go through the church. The musicians on the Cape, church musicians, are very well connected through the American Guild of Organists or just by word of mouth.
Do you have a website?
I do. It's on artistsandmusicians.org. I have a webpage there.
Okay, very good. Joan, it's been a pleasure. Thank you so much for your time.
You.
I know how busy you are, and good luck with all of the great work that you have.
Thank you very much.
We will look forward to seeing you. Thank you.